Here on WingateBulldogs.com, Ryan Brown at Wingate Men's Basketball Practice. The Bulldogs getting ready for their first SAC matchup of the year, road contest at Catawba. With us today, Brian Good, Wingate Men's Basketball Head Coach. Coach, not only is the first conference game of the year, it's on the road where you guys, you know, struggling in your only matchup. How much will you take from that first game at Barton, or is this a different team after a couple great wins last week against two Peach Belt teams?
Probably a little bit of both. Yeah, I think we found ourselves a little bit last week, but in basketball, I think that's fleeting. And if we don't do the same things that we've been doing, we could be back just like Barton and struggling to get things done. So, but if we'll stick to the things that have treated us well here this last week, I feel pretty good about us.
Coach, so much to be said about a team's early season schedules. You guys play some tough opponents. Some teams in the league have not. It's hard to get a read on them. Catawba, one of those teams that played a couple strong teams, a couple teams that haven't been very strong. How tough is it to get a read on a team this early in the year?
Yeah, I think we got a pretty good feel of who they are, and I think Coach Baker's teams have been pretty consistent through the years on what they emphasize and what they do. And I think they're, I just told our team, I think they're young, but they're very talented. And that's a team that, you got to do a good job early and keep them from getting started when you have young players. And I think that's reflected in their wins and losses.
Coach, five seniors, through their first five games, 3-2. Again, tough teams, but again, to go on and start this year 1-0 with such a big break before your next conference. How much will you rely on these veteran guys to get you guys through tomorrow night?
Well, I mean, it's their year, it's their season. If they, they're the one that's going to determine our destiny. If they show up ready to play, on the road against a conference foe, then I think everybody else will fall, and I wouldn't expect any less from them.
Coach, through five games, you can start realizing some trends of a team, maybe not through the first couple, and especially the next 10 or 12 games. What have been the trends so far in the three wins, and what are the things that, have been the losses and the trends that you have to do well tomorrow night?
Well, I think without a doubt, and our trademark is the same, and we've defended in our wins, and in both of our losses, I didn't think it was typical defense of us, and for whatever reason, we've seemed to have fought through that a little bit. Maybe got a little bit more cohesive defensively, and two teams that were really good off the dribble and maybe exposed some things that for the future, like an Anderson that we know that we need to do a better job of prepping for.
I know you haven't made a lot of about it, but being picked to finish first in a league, what is that? As a coaching staff, how do you take that, knowing this is your first conference game and people have an eye on you, just like they will Anderson, LMU. The three of you all been in the top of the league in the last 2 years.
Yeah, I've thought about it. We've talked about it. But the one thing we've all agreed on is we don't need to talk about it with our guys. They're better in the underdog role, and they're better in the no respect role, and they always have been, because I think that's who they are as people. So we won't talk about that. Catawba's going to want to beat us whether we're pick number one or number 10, and certainly we expect nothing but their best effort.
Coach, best of luck tomorrow night.
Thanks, Ryan.
Back for part two of our Wingate Men's Basketball Practice Report. Joining us now, SAC Player of the Week, Odell Turner. Odell averaging a double-double last year, has that on the season. Oh, how big were those two wins for this team last week, coming off the disappointing loss to Barton and heading into conference play?
They were huge. It was big that we got confidence early, so we can win early games early, because we know we'll be good down the stretch. But getting off to a good start, that would be huge for us, especially for us seniors.
Preseason All-SAC for you, a big week last week. What were you able to do? A couple offensive rebound putbacks, a couple post-up moves, finding a way to score in different ways. How important is that for your success?
Scoring early was big for me, getting confidence in the game, and like you said, getting easy baskets, layups, and hitting free throws. So, I took a lot of high percentage shots, and hopefully I can keep getting high percentage.
Four out of your five first games have been at home. The only game on the road was a loss at Barton. What did you learn from that night, and how much will you think about that night as you head into the game against Catawba?
We learned a lot from it. Barton's a good team, and we just have to be ready and play at a high level on the road every game, because we're going to get everybody's best.
Again, five seniors on this team, leadership for these senior class, road game, the first game for a conference opponent. Catawba's a great rival. You guys are picked to win the league. I mean, a lot going into a first game. Where would the message be for these younger guys coming up tomorrow night?
They'll see how the conference games are. I mean, they're pretty different from every other game because Catawba obviously knows what we do and we know what they do. So it'll be more grind, kind of a grinded out game.
Odell, thanks a lot, man. Good luck against Indians.
Thank you.